8.2 polygons. A polygon is a closed figure in a plane determined by three or more straight line segments. So a polygon is any shape as long as it's closed. The straight line segment that form the polygon are called its sides, and a point where two sides meet is called its vertex, plural vertices. The unit of the side of a polygon and its interior angles, or excuse me, in its interior is called a polygonal region. A regular polygon is one whose sides are all the same length and whose interior angles all have the same measure. So, polygons are named according to their number of sides. So, three sides triangle, four sides quadrilateral, five sides pentagon, six sides hexagon, seven sides heptagon, eight sides octagon, nine nonagon, 10 decagon, 12 dodecagon, 20 isosagon. The sides, so if you have three sides, you have one triangle, and that means to find the interior angles, it all equals 180. The sum of interior angles for a four-sided, so rectangle square, is 2 times 180, which is 360. So 5 sides, that's three triangles, so 3 times 80, 180, and so on. But we really don't use this measurement. The formula we use to find the interior angles is n minus 2 times 180. So the sum of the measures of the interior angles of an inside-sided polygon is n minus 2 times 180. N is the number of sides. So types of triangles. We have acute triangles. All angles are acute. Obtuse triangles. One angle is obtuse. A right triangle. One angle is right. Isosceles. Two equal sides. Two equal angles. Equilateral. So everything is equal. You have three equal angles at 60 degrees each. You have scalene triangles, which no two sides are equal in length. All right, example one. Lines L1 and L2 are parallel. Determine the measures of angles 1 through 12. So let's find all the measures. So we know that if they share the same vertice, that they have the same length. So opposite of 65, we're going to have a 65. Opposite of a 60, we have a 60. And that's all for opposite. So let's talk about this triangle. We know that the sum of a triangle equals 180 degrees. So if we have 65 degrees plus 60 degrees, what's the next angle? We don't know. So we combine like terms, we get 65 and 60. Another way that you can do this is just knowing you add up the angles and you subtract it from 180. But this is explaining that every single angle, which there are three angles in a triangle, they equal 180 degrees. So we do the 65 and 60, we get, sorry, my throat, 125 plus x equals 180. Subtract 125. So we get our x equals 50. Sorry, I didn't mean to put 50, I put 55 degrees. So the measure of angle 7 is 55 degrees. That means the measure of angle 12 is 55 degrees, just because they share the same vertice. Now we need to find the remaining angles. So we need to find 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 10, and 11. No big deal. So let's find the measure of angle 1. Let's see if we can find that. Do we have enough information to find it at this point? Probably not. So let's just keep going to figure out where we can figure out how we can still keep and approach this. So do you notice any corresponding angles? So I'll put them in green. So we have a corresponding angle 1 and 7. So by default, the measure of angle 1 is 55 degrees. Now we can find the measure of angle 2 because the angle opposite of angle 2, well, we already found 2. Never mind. All right, so next we move on. We need to find 3. So notice the bottom left angle of the triangle, known as 60 degrees. So you see the bottom right here, the 60 right here. Maybe you can see it. Is a vertical angle with 4. So they're the same thing. They're vertical angles, and vertical angles are equal. So that means this 60 degrees right here is the same for 4. Next, let's find the measure of angle 5. So the angle opposite of angle 5, it has a value of 55. So opposite would be 55. Oh, wrong color. And then opposite of 3, can you see it? It's 60. See it right here? So let's find the measure of angle 6. So the angle on the right side of angle 6 is valued at 60, and it's supplementary with angle 6. So to find the measure of angle 6, because it's supplementary, it's 180 degrees minus 60, and we get 30 degrees. Sorry, I don't know, how's that a complementary, not supplementary, 120 degrees. My mind keeps thinking of complementary. So measure of angle 6 is 120 degrees. That means the measure of angle 10 is 120 degrees because it's opposite. Now all we have left is 8 and 11. So we do the same procedure with 8 and 11. We're going to subtract it from the one next to it because it's supplementary. So the measure of angle 8 is 180 minus 55, and we get 125. So the measure of angle 8 is 125. That means the measure of angle 11 is 125. So let me put this all out for you. All right, so listed we have all the measures to the left in black, just in case you can't see it on the diagram. So for this example, you're gonna have to pull back to 8.1 and really understand corresponding angles, alternate interior, alternate exterior, stuff like that. All right, example 2, determine the measure of an interior angle of the named polygon. If a side of the polygon is extended, determine the supplementary angle of an interior angle, so dodecagon. So dodecagon is 12 sides. So to find the measure of the interior angles, we use the formula n minus 2 times 180 degrees. And in this case, n is 12 sides. So we have 12 minus 2 times 180. So 10 times 180. And we get 1800 degrees. That means if you were to draw a dodecagon out and you add up all of the interior angles, it's 1800 degrees. So just like a circle, or a triangle, it's 180 degrees. And for a rectangle, it's 360 degrees. All right, so part B. It wants to find if you draw the dodecagon. So pretend that this is the dodecagon. I obviously can't draw it because it's extremely hard. So let's just say that's the dodecagon. So if I extended this out, what would that angle be? So we need to know how much each angle in the dodecagon is. So it's the sum of interior angles over the number of sides. Because we want to know if the whole thing is 1800 degrees, how much is each side? So that's 1800 degrees divided by 12, and you get 150 degrees. That means This angle right here, one of them, that's 150 degrees. So it wants to find the supplementary. So to find the supplementary, that's 180 minus 150, and we get 30 degrees. That means x would be 30. All right, similar figures. Two figures are similar if their corresponding angles have the same measure and the length of their corresponding sides are in proportion. All right, this means CB is proportional to FE. BA or AB, doesn't matter, is proportional to ED, meaning they share the same ratio, so like 1 to 2. So for example 3, let's find, oh, sorry, I forgot one. CA or AC is proportional to FD or DF. All right, so for example 3, let's find x and y. So what we're trying to find in x, that's side AB. Those little apostrophes mean you're working with a similar figure. So the proportional side to AB is AB without the or without the little apostrophe. So now we want to put another side on. So a side that we have on the proportion side is AD. We use it because they give us a number, and then the proportion, the similar side to AD is AD without the apostrophes. So AB, we don't know that. That's why the similar figure of AD, we know 27.5, AB is 21, and AD is, excuse me, yeah, AD is 22. So from here we cross multiply. So when we cross multiply, we do 22 times y, which is 22y. We do 21 times 27.5, and we get 577.5. We divide by 22. So we get y equals 26.25. Now we need to find x. So in order to find x, we can use the same numbers that we just used. So to find x, that's DC with the little apostrophe. And then the corresponding side to that is DC without the apostrophe. And a value we have is AD and AD. You see how we're just using the same values? All right, so the similar DC, we don't know it. Similar AD, we do. It's 27.5, and that equals DC, which is 20, over AD, which is 22. We do the same thing. We cross multiply. So we do 22 times x is 22x. 27.5 times 20 is 550. We divide by 22. We get x equals 25. So DC is 25. All right, let's do another similar figure problem. Triangles ABC and DEC in the similar figure to the right are similar figures. Determine the length of BC. So we want to figure out what BC is. All right, so we have DE. We have it. It's 1. We have AB. AB, it's 14. And that equals our proportion triangle, so our little triangle. So on our little triangle, we have EC, and we're trying to find BC. So DE is 1, AB is 14, EC is 1, we don't know BC, so we cross multiply to get BC equals 14. Congruent figures, if a corresponding side of two similar figures are the same length, then the figures are congruent. Corresponding angles of congruent figures have the same measures. So if they're proportional, like we did in the past two examples, their angles are the same. So if we want to find the angle of A right here, it's the same thing. So 78. If we want to know the missing side for, or excuse me, missing angle for B, we know that that's 180 minus 26 minus 78, and we get 76. That means this B is 76 degrees, and this C is 26 degrees. And that's all we're trying to find. We're just trying to find the measures of the angles, not the sides. All right, so Monique plans to remove a tree from her backyard. She needs to know the height of the tree. Monique is 6 feet tall and determines that when her shadow is 9 feet long, the shadow of the tree is 45 feet long. There's a figure. So how tall is the tree? So we have the little triangle right here. So that's 6 over x, because the similar side to that is x. And then that equals other values we have. Part of the little triangle is 9, and the big triangle is 45. We cross multiply. We have 9x equals 270. Divide by 9, we get x equals 30. So that means the tree is 30 feet tall. All right, example 7. A triangle can be formed by drawing line segments on a map of Texas connecting the cities of Dallas, Houston, and San Antonio. If the actual distance from San Antonio to Houston is approximately 186 miles, use the length of the line segments to segments indicated in the figure. So find the actual distance from Dallas to Houston and find the actual distance from Dallas to San Antonio. So it gives us a bit of information. San Antonio to Houston is actually 186 miles. So San Antonio to Houston, 186 miles. So 186 miles is 3 inches on this map. So let's do part A. So part A is Dallas to Houston. We want to find this right here, Dallas to Houston. So Dallas to Houston on the map is 3.75. We don't know how big it is in actual miles, so that's x. And then that equals, we know 3 inches is 186 miles. So we cross multiply. We get 3x equals 697.5, divide by 3. So we get x is 232.5 miles. So from Dallas to Houston, it's actually 232 miles. All right, part B. We want to know Dallas to San Antonio. So right here, Dallas to San Antonio. So Dallas, we know, is 4.125 inches. We don't know the big distance, the actual miles. And then that equals, we do the same thing, 3 over 186. So we get 3x equals 767.25, divide by 3. So x equals 255.75 miles. Quadrilaterals are four-sided polygons, the sum of whose interior angles is 360. Quadrilaterals may be classified according to their characteristics. So a trapezoid is two sides are parallel. Parallelogram, both pairs of opposite sides are parallel, both pair of opposite sides are equal in length, a rhombus or a diamond, both pairs of opposite sides are parallel, the four sides are equal in length, so it's just like a parallelogram, but it's like the square version. A rectangle, both pair of opposite sides are parallel, both pair of opposite sides are equal in its length, the angles are right angles. And then we have a square, everything is equal.